Hi, I'm Kevin from InQuality at IBC Show 2019 here in Amsterdam. We are here at the miniature Comrex stand. We've both gone for miniature stands this time around. It's neat, isn't it?
Well, it's a pod, and pods are mod, I guess. I mean, that's the thing to do this year.
It's great here. There's loads of passing trade with people going between halls 7 and 8. Chris, you've got some exciting stuff going on. All of the up-to-date Access NX ranges here.
Yeah, our Access rack mount products, starting with the Access NX rack, has just started to ship. And soon we hope to be shipping the Access MultiRack, which is five Access units in a single 19-inch rack mount. So that's five stereo full duplex channels in a single 19-inch rack mount device.
That's the exciting thing. And with that, you don't need five different audio in-outs on the back. It all comes out on AES-67, right?
All on a standard Ethernet connector using the AES-67 compatible interface. So it can work with Axios LiveWire, Wheatnet, Dante, Ravenna, and many of the audio console digital routing systems that support Ravenna.
Great. So we can take five different SIP streams from five different devices, five different locations, send them into that one unit, and then you can send them out into your studio complex wherever you need them.
It is a beautiful thing, isn't it?
It sounds like a beautiful thing to me. It absolutely does. And tell us more about the portable NX, because that's, I remember when I used to use Comrex devices on the road, it was the older version with the battery pack on the back. Tell us the difference between that and this updated version.
So the Access 2 USB has been our most popular product probably of all time, and we really needed to make sure that when we updated it, because it's a 15-year-old product, the 2 USB, we needed to make sure that we added the things that customers really wanted. So we actually added an additional mic or line level input and headphone output. So the base unit has two mic or line level inputs and headphone outputs. It has digital encoders, so you don't get any of that noisy scratching sound when you're adjusting gain or the headphone volume. There's also peak input limiting on all of the mic pre-inputs, so it has a nice, gentle knee to it, so if someone yells, "Go!" really loud, it's not going to digitally clip right and basically take you off the air.
Which is an issue with a lot of, you know, USB audio interfaces and things that people are using now. You don't get any limiting or dynamics built into those things as standard, and a lot of codecs don't have that, so that's a great feature.
So limiting is really important. So it's circuit protection, it's audio protection, and it's a nice feature. And you also have a multi-segment LED on all of the gain knobs, so you can actually see the volume level based on your volume into that input. So it goes green, yellow, red. 5-inch capacitive touchscreen, so you don't have to use a stylus anymore. And then the lithium battery, the lithium ion battery pack is actually on the inside of the unit instead of hanging off the bottom like the previous unit. So we've done a lot of things.
And how long would you say you get on a bad day, how many hours of battery life are you getting out of that?
5 hours, but typically 5 to 6 hours of battery life on that device.
And that's in active use, yeah?
In active use, even with phantom power. So 5 hours with phantom power if you're using that on multiple mics.
Great, I like it. And what about connectivity options? There's an Ethernet socket on the back. What else do you have?
There's two USB ports on there as well. So you can actually have three networks. You could have a Wi-Fi. There's a Wi-Fi modem that comes with the unit. You could use a 4G LTE modem. You could use one of our custom-made 4G LTE modems that supports Verizon, AT&T, and then bands throughout the entire world. So we actually have two international modems that support every band outside of the U.S.
Which is great if you're a worldwide journalist heading off to cover news stories, yeah?
Or you're a broadcaster in Europe or a broadcaster in Asia. So we have modems to cover everyone where we have clients.
Sounds great. Chris, I wish you a wonderful rest of IBC Show, and we'll see you next time.
Indeed, I'll look forward to it.
And if you want to find out more about this kind of technology, make sure you subscribe to this YouTube channel.